Hi, my name is Wolfram Wagner. Some time ago, Rick Beato made his video of the top 20 keyboard intros. I think there are some keyboard intros that I should mention that were not in his list. Welcome to my list of the other 20 top keyboard intros. Let me start with an intro that was played by a band which for a long time had no keyboard player in them. Then one time the keyboard player joined, and this is the intro from the first record they made with this keyboard player, a piano intro. A song by a real hard rock band, playing with lots of guitar all the times, this time intro by their keyboarder, which was in Personal Union, the bass player. In the same song, later there was a short break, which was already filled by the same instrument. Now from one of my absolute favorite bands with one of the greatest keyboarders alive. A very versatile keyboarder that really plays all of those keyboard instruments very, very well. And here he starts off with a short but fantastic piano intro. Next in my list is a keyboard intro just starting off with the chords that go on during the first part of the song. Next is from a soul song with a very large arrangement, and it starts off with piano and polyphone synthesizer. Now a very funky song. Originally it starts off with some kind of synthesizer, but I found that it's perfectly suited for a clavinet. Ever heard about Mordent? No clue what this is? Well, similar to a trill or something, this is something that you put on one note, you just write one note, and it's abbreviation to do a little change about this note. This one, if you never heard the name, you definitely heard it one time. A very, very well-known classic piece starts with one note with a mordent, and it goes like this. The first song that I will show you now that is deeply inspired by this opening is an organ improvisation as far as I know, one of the first ever to use a distorted organ sound. It's by a band which is called, well, The Band. Now is the first video that I show you which uses lots of different keyboards. It starts off with some sounds that were mixed together, and then when it ends up with church bells, it goes into a church organ sound. Then it goes back and it comes a short improvisation with a synthesizer sound reminiscent of a guitar with a lot of pitch bending, and then with a very low organ sound, it brings the intro of the actual song that follows up a hard rock song. Now let me play three intros in a row. Each uses the keyboard and effects to create a vast space of sound. The first one uses two synthesizer tracks. One to play a melody and the other one a deep and mighty bass. We'll be right back. Now we'll move on to the master of the pitching wheel. In this song, he uses the pitch bending with lots of echo and reverb to create a real big empty space where you should imagine Earth in search for the sun. What makes a really experienced musician? Well, he knows when too much is too much. This one is really exceptional. It uses an extreme echo, reverb and a Leslie effect. For years I could not spot what instrument it was. And let me tell you, it was just for a long time the same note, a single note, again and again and again. And for this song, it was the perfect match. You know the great thing about a monophonic synthesizer? Well, you can change just about everything with the sound. One of the things you can do, you can use the pitch wheel to do extreme pitch changes. You can tune down the instrument so far that the tone is a rhythm. Or you can start with this rhythm and turn it up until you get into a note. Now here used as an intro. Next is very simple from principle, but it's just some amazing chords in a row that really lead into the feeling of the song that comes after it. Again, an intro by a band which had no keyboard before this. A keyboard intro on piano, which for a long time plays around with harmonies and everything, and later goes over to a little jamming around with a guitar player before it goes into one of the greatest hard rock songs. a very short organ intro before the guitar comes in, but it's brilliant. Now the same keyboard player, same band, and again the keyboard starts, this time with a very mighty fanfare-like intro that then is doubled by the guitar in the further part of the song. Next is an intro which just consists of one organ sound and a very deep synthesized bass sound. And it's just more or less the chords and a bass melody. Next is an intro from a band with a B3 in a hard rock band, and this intro is an undistorted B3 and it's just more or less the chords and the rhythm, and this rhythm is rather strange. Try to spot where the one is without counting. Again, an organ intro. The intro is short, but it leads to a very famous song which took 17 minutes of run length. It was used with The Simpsons one time. What can you do with three chords playing over and over again from a very famous song? And this intro is not from the original version, it's from a cover. A cover that I think is more famous than the original. Next thing is fantastic. It starts off with an organ melody. If you heard it one time, you will never forget it, with lots of reverb, lots of echo on it, and it's a landmark. next is from a live recording. It's a large intro only played by the organ, and it uses the effects available at the time. It uses the ring modulator. It uses the organ in its pure sound. It uses the organ in its completely distorted sound with a Marshall amplifier, and it uses the spring reverb for thundering effects. And it's a lot of improvisation before it leads over to the real song. The player once in an interview stated this as one of the two things in his life he was most proud of. And believe me, I do understand it.